Good evening. Our top story, an important meeting being held at the residence of the Prime Minister, being attended not just by the Prime Minister, but by Mr. Mallikarjun Kharge of the Congress Party and also Justice Sikri, who's been nominated by the Chief Justice of India to attend on the process of selection of the CBI Chief. This is after the CBI Chief, Mr. Verma, who was taken away from his position, was in fact reinstated after he was sent on leave for some time. But now the status of his post, the status of the CBI Chief's post, is something that's going to be discussed by the same panel that was responsible for the appointment of the CBI Chief in the first place.
कल हमने कहा था सीवीसी का रिपोर्ट हमको नहीं मिला है, जब तक हम नहीं पढ़ेंगे अपनी राय नहीं बता सकेंगे, हमारे उनके क्या व्यूज हैं देखेंगे, फिर हमारी बात क्या रखना है वो रखेंगे।
My colleague Neeta Sharma joins us now for the very latest on this. Neeta, what exactly is the agenda for this meeting?
Agenda is very clear, Vishnu, whether the sitting CBI director, Mr. Alok Verma, would be continuing for next 20 days or would he be sent on leave yet again. Because Mr. Alok Verma, since the time he has joined back CBI headquarters as the CBI head, has again started confronting the government. He had made about 13 transfers last night. Today also he has made 5 transfers. Officers have been transferred, earlier who were transferred by Mr. Nageshwar Rao have been transferred back. One of the officers, M.K. Sinha, he's a 2000 batch IPS officer. He was asked to look after anti-corruption unit number 3. This is a very important unit because this was looking into charges against Mr. Rakesh Asthana. However, Mr. M.K. Sinha wrote back to CBI and said that he does not want to take over as a probing head for that case. And that is why in the today's transfer, he has been asked to take care of anti-corruption unit number 1. Another officer, a very contentious officer, is Mr. A.K. Sharma. He was joint director policy. Now he has been asked to take care of anti-corruption unit number 1. He is the same officer against whom Mr. Rakesh Asthana had leveled charges that he had gone to his hometown and had started investigations in his daughter's wedding, when what kind of guests had come, what kind of expenses were made in his daughter's wedding. So these are the officers who have been transferred back. As far as the select committee is concerned, the role of Justice A.K. Sikri is very important. It is on whose side he would be upon, that would be the side which would eventually win. The ratio would be 2-1. Mr. Kharge's position is clearly known. He yesterday also had said, stuck down 4 points. First, he had said that the CVC report, which had, said there are corruption charges against Mr. Alok Verma, should be shared with him. The 77 days when Mr. Alok Verma was sent on leave should be compensated, and Mr. Alok Verma should be called before the select committee to depose. And whatever transpired on October 23rd should be investigated by a high-powered, empowered committee. So this is the stand of the Congress party. So it is clearly known that even if Justice A.K. Sikri sides with the Prime Minister, Mr. Kharge would be giving a dissenting note. So in this meeting today, the first most important thing is the future of the sitting CBI director, Mr. Alok Verma. The second most important thing is that Mr. Alok Verma is all set to retire on January 31st. So a selection panel has also been, set in motion. The government has already impaneled about 20 officers, among whom about 4 officers would be shortlisted. There are names of 1983, 84 and 85 batch officers which are doing round, who would be selected finally for the final number 4. So the select committee also needs to look out for a new CBI director. But today the focus would be solely on Mr. Alok Verma, whether he would be staying as the CBI director or no. Vishnu?